La, I have a, you know, I have a big car, I have a big this, I have a big that. Akhi, know that it is just to make you feel more comfortable. And our kids, listen, they are growing up, man. They are growing up. Wallahi, this is not the place to raise our kids. One of the things that our brother Dhulqarnain mentioned when he went to Gambia, he said, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. This is a better place to raise my kids. And this is a man that was born, he don't know nothing but America. He don't know nothing but America. He don't know nothing but America. And he know the darknesses of America. I'm saying it behind his back. He know the darknesses of America. For those who understand what I'm saying, perhaps they understand what I'm saying. He know the darknesses of America. So if he's saying this, فَمَا بَالُكَ أَنْتَ وَأَنَا. So the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, so we were mentioning in regard to this third type of khawf. Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he called it al-khawf al-sirri, al-khawf al-sirri, the hidden fear, the hidden fear. He say, كان يخاف صاحب القبر, like the individual, he fear for the grave that is in Touba. He's right here in Atlanta or in New York. And this individual, this people of innovation, now you find them doing like a Bamba Day in New York, where all these guys being dressed like crazy and is chanting this qasida, thinking that this is the deen. Thinking that this is victory. Why? Because we're chanting the qasida of Bamba in New York, in the capital of the disbelievers land, the greatest city in the whole world. We singing the songs of Bamba. For them, this is a victory. Allah is giving us victory. This is foolishness. This is being out of your mind. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the Sahaba Ridwanul, and now this, when the Sahaba Ridwanullah alayhim ajma'in, after the conquest of Mecca, they did not, barakallahu fikum, be going back and forth to Mecca and, you know, going in around the streets of Mecca, commemorating the victory of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam over the disbelievers. That's not happening. But this individual basing their religion upon following somebody before Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you will find those who will miss the salah, and those who, barakallah fikum, al-ikhtilat bayna al-nisa wal-rijal, yani the what you call it, the free mixing between man and woman. You know, woman all, subhanallah al-azim, men all du'afa, da'if jiddan. That you now, for them, this is a sense of victory. Because we reading the qasaid, or the chanting the songs of Bamba in the streets of New York. Now look how of a high esteem they have about a city. Now this shows you, barakallahu fikum, the majority of the people today, they only following their desires. Only following their desires, wal'iyadhu billah. The Shaykh Hafidhahullah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he mentioned, he say that the third type is the khawfu sirri, the hidden fear. He say, ka'an yakhafu sahibu al-qabr, like the individual fear the person that is in his grave. He fear the person that is in the grave. Awwaliyan. I'm sorry? No, this is another book. This is another book. Naam, Uthulu Thalath, Iftah. Follow with him, inshallah, please. And I believe it's in page 57, if I'm not mistaken. Hakada? 37, huh? Well, in my tabaqa is 57. Ala kullin. At the very last paragraph, he say, An-naw'u thalith, the third category is khawfu sirri, the hidden fear. He say, كَأَنْ يَخَافُ صاحب القبر, like the individual, he's fearing, he fear the person in the grave. أوليا بعيدا عنه, or he's fearing someone, a wali, that is far away, removed from him, that is far away, distance from him. He is right here in Atlanta, and he has this fear in regard to Ahmed Tijan in Fas, in Morocco. He has the fear in him. And he say, لا يؤثر فيه. It doesn't have no outward effect. ولكنه يخافه. But he fears him. مخافة سري. He fears him a secret way. He fear him a secret way. And you find this in the majority of the Quburiyin. In the majority of those who worship the graves. So the Shah Hafidhahu Allah, he say, فَهَذَا أَيْضًا ذَكَرَهُ الْعُلَمَاء مِنَ الشِّرْكِ. And this also, it is as the ulama has defined it to be part of, to be part of shirk. This is why Shah Hafidhahu Allah gave us two. The fear that is the ibadah and slash shirk, and the fear that is tabi'i. طيب, the fear that is ibadah slash shirk, and the fear that is tabi'i, the natural fear. But Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala, he gave the third one in detail to show, and this is something that you will find in the hearts of the majority of these people today, wal'iyadhu billah. They will fear. If they do not, and as one of the brothers, alhamdulillah for him standing firm upon this, as his family wanted him to participate in slaughtering an animal that their father used to do every year. He said, no, there is no proof in the Sunnah, or there is no proof in the Quran and the Sunnah that we have to do this. So not knowing that there could be something attached to it, that perhaps that he was slaughtering, barakallahu fikum, for the grave of his sheikh, or he was slaughtering for on behalf of his sheikh and the like, fearing that if he does not do so, or slaughtering for the jinn to repel the harm of the jinn, or to bring about benefit that he is seeking from them. Now kullu hadha barakallahu fikum shirk. All of this, it is sometimes it is shirk. Wal'iyadhu billah. So the Shaykh Hafidhahullah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he mentioned. So the verse of Allah, when Allah Jalla say, فَلَا تَخَافُوهُمْ وَخَافُونِ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. When Allah Jalla Allah say in Surah Ali Imran, verse number 175, and do not fear them, but fear me if you truly believe, if you truly believers. هذه الآية في سورة آل عمران في قصة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مع المشركين يوم أحد. He said that this is the event, or one of the events in the life of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he was يعني in opposition, or he was fighting against the mushriks in Uhud. When he was fighting against the mushrik in Uhud, who won that fight? Who won that fight? Afakallah. Now, the question was, who won that battle? The Uhud, the battle of Uhud. The mushrikun. Who was one of the main ones from the mushrik that really flipped the battle? Ahsanta. Ahsanta, ya Aba Ahmed. Tashrab al kahwa? Huh? You got it. Khalid ibn Walid. Ahsanta. وكان مشركا رضي الله عنه وارضاه رضي الله عنه وارضاه. He was the main one that بارك الله فيكم changed, because when he seen those that were, how you call there, the archers, بارك الله فيك عبد الحميد, you will come next to me, man. The archers, right? Because the messenger appointed them to be on the mountain, and he told them, doesn't matter what happened, do not come down. No matter, even if they would have slaughtered us to the last of us, do not come down. But قَدَّرَ اللَّهُ وَمَا شَافَعَ, what had happened, happened. And when Khalid ibn Walid, he seen that those archers was coming down, then he went around, they, him and a portion of the kuffar, they went around, And barakallahu fikum, this is when that there was the, that's where the first, that was the first defeat, or the first defeat that the Muslim barakallahu fikum that they had encountered. And all of this bi qadrillahi wa qada'ihi. So the Shahidahu Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he say, لما توعدهم المشركون لما توعدهم المشركون, when the mushrikeens, they have, yani they promise him, in other words, they promise him, وقالوا نرجع, because after Uhud was like a big L that the mushrikeen took. It was a big loss for the mushrikeen. And up to that day, barakallahu fikum, and in Uhud, it was a very bitter defeat that they had. Because many of the elders of the Quraysh, or the elite of the Quraysh, was killed. Many of them was killed. And it was very honorable for them, for 300 and some, to be defeating about 900 and some, or up to 1,000. This was really, barakallahu fikum, something that was what? That was very shameful. Very shameful. So therefore, the mushrikeen of the Quraysh, tawa'adahum, they promised them, qalu narji' ilayhim, that we will come back to them. Wa nastalihim, and then we will fight them, we will kill them, we will wipe them out. Fallahu jalla wa ala yaqul, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, innama dhalikum ash-shaytan, that this is only the shaytan, يُخَوِّفُ أَوْلِيَاءَهُ, that they are putting fear in us, the believers, in from the, meaning in regard to the allies of the mushrikeen, the allies of the shayateen. Allah said, فَلَا تَخَافُوهُمْ, do not fear them. وَخَافُونِي, fear me, إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ, fear me if you truly believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أي أن هذا التهديد وهذا الوعيد إِنَّمَا هُوَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ, he say all these threats and all this promise and the like, it is only from the shaitan. Don't listen to them. Don't fear them. يُخَوِّفُكُمْ أَوْلِيَاءَهُ, meaning that they are putting fear in your hearts, meaning in regard to his allies, meaning the allies of the shaitan, or the helpers of the shaitan. مِنْ إِنْقَادِ لَهُ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَخَافَ مِنْهُ, so that they will, barakallahu fikum, take revenge from them, and they will destroy them, and they will beat them. And so therefore, they have this fear in the hearts of the people. He say, فَإِنَّهُ سَيَصِلْ عَلَيْهِمْ, say, all of this will go against them. All of this that the shaitan was trying will go against them. And this is because that they truly believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this conclude, barakallahu al-jami' the dalil for al-khawf. So bi-idhnillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala wa dalilu al-raja qawluhu ta'ala, faman kana yarju liqa'a rabbihi falyamal amalan saliha wala yushrik bi-ibadati rabbihi ahada. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf, verse 110, he say, faman kana yarju, whoever hope, liqa'a rabbihi, to the meeting of his Lord, فَلْيَعْمَلْ, let him do عَمَلًا صَالِحًا, righteous actions. Let him do righteous actions. And righteous actions was not left for all of us to come together and define what is a righteous action. Righteous action was not left to us to see the region that we came from, what is a righteous action, and to define righteous action being righteous action. Righteous actions, as the ulama define, and we'll come to it, it is that which, barakallahu fikum, ma wafaqa shartaini. It is that which fall into these two conditions. Number one, al-ikhlas wal-mutaba'a. Al-kitab wa sunnah. Hakada, al-kitab. Al-ikhlas, having sincerity for Allah, meaning the tawheed of Allah. And the second one is the mutaba'a, compliant to the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he say, wala yushrik, and do not ascribe bi ibadati rabbi.